Here we are with the Hunter Next RS35, one of the four boats that we're looking at down here at the Swanwick Used Boat Show. She's an impressive example, considering that this boat is a 1990 boat and the condition of the gel coat is nothing but quite superb. Clearly, I think at some point someone spent a lot of money on having her repainted and re-graphicked. New anti-fouling, stern drive serviced and re-anti-fouled, new anodes. There's not really a stone unturned with this boat. The Hunton XRS35, like its modern Hunton counterparts today, has got a great deep V hull. However, let's go astern and take a look at the stern drives. Here we have early generation DPB Volvo duo props. I suspect at some point both of these stern drive legs, possibly the transom shields, have been replaced. I say that because the condition of the graphics here is pretty superb, and I know that a few years ago Volvo were doing these new stern drive legs at very reasonable prices. They've all been re-anti-fouled, new anodes, the props are in good nick. However, I will say that this port side stern drive has got a bit of wear and tear in the steering yoke going through the transom shield. You can see that with by turning it from port to starboard. It's common, it's not bad, but the starboard one, that's still good and tight. Here we are in the cockpit. Impressively, it's still all original. The original red GRP at the helm. All the upholstery is still original with the red piping around the corners of the seat. It's got some modern electronics, a few here and there, like a modern standard Horizon radio, slightly newer chart plotter than the boat. Otherwise, the rest of it is all original and in pretty pristine condition. All the covers have been replaced. You can clearly see that by the nice clear windows and the clinically clean white zips. All the GRP is perfect, very impressive. Okay, let's lift the engine hatch. Well, here we have a very nice pair of 200 horsepower Volvo ADP 41s. Big, tough, understressed engine blocks, turbo but not supercharged. These engines will clock up quite a few hours without any problems, and looking at these engines, they look in pretty good nick. Well, here we are below in the saloon, and surprisingly for a sharp hulled pedigree boat like this, it's actually got a reasonable amount of accommodation. Yeah, about 6'4" of headroom all the way through right to the forward berth in the forepeak. In there we have a heads, compact but workable, with a shower, single hob, bit of a storage there on the port side, microwave up there. Yeah, impressive actually. Here we are with the 1989 Trader 47, just £115,000, so it's a lot of boat and not a lot of money, but like with some older boats, especially the bigger ones, there's a bit of TLC and there's a bit of maintenance to be done. Anti-fouling, some of the stern gear needs a bit of a scrub up and sorting out, and obviously things like fatigue and the GRP. Here we are in the saloon of the Trader. As you can see, very spacious, plenty of room, good all-round visibility. It's been retrospectively reupholstered. As you can see, black upholstery, black fittings, black helm. Not to everyone's taste, but then again, of course, it can be easily changed should you want to. Here we are in the cockpit, very spacious as you can see, lots of room. Four steps quickly up to the flybridge, steps down to the bathing platform. However, the teak needs a bit of TLC, because that's the downside of a big boat at this age and this size. Well, here we are with the 2008 Sea Lion SC38, priced at £130,000, which is pretty reasonable considering she's in very good condition for her age. cockpit design has always been a strong point with Sea Lion, and certainly so with the SC-38. They get every last centimetre of space and lovely contemporary styling, fantastic visibility all the way around, very modern contemporary dash. You're in no doubt that this is a modern motorboat. And a sunroof, not electric, but it's very easily operated by hand. Well, the saloon, I think light is the order of the day here. These windows in the coach roof, they're just letting a huge amount of light. Gives you a great feeling of space. Very modern contemporary design. Here, we have a toilet with ensuite access to the master cabin. On this side, a shower, likewise with ensuite access. And here we have double master cabin. And amidships, there is a guest cabin undersole. Well, if you take a look around, this 2008 boat is clearly in outstanding, very lightly used condition. In fact, it appears the cooker hasn't even been used. Well, here we are with Lady Cleo, a Westwood 38, an aft cabin designed very much like a broom, a 2005 boat, and at just £130,000, I think she represents pretty good value for money. So let's go on board and take a look. Here we are in the saloon. It's the traditional saloon up, galley and dinette down arrangement. Got a galley, a U-shaped galley to the starboard side with a three-ring flush ceramic hob and two stainless steel sinks and a decent sized oven. To port, you've got a very decent dinette that was accommodate about four people. There's a double cabin forward, master aft cabin with ensuite shower and ensuite heads. My money's on the Hunton. Rarely do you get such a boat with such a pedigree at this age in such remarkable, immaculate, original condition. At 45k, definitely.